Dear students, welcome to Gnana Diksha Concept Based Digital Learning. I am D. Swati, lecturer in physics at Telangana Social Welfare Residential Degree College for Women, Vikarabad. Today, I would like to discuss Biot-Savart's law and its applications from the topic magnetostatics. Magnetostatics is a branch of physics which deals with unchanging magnetic fields. Biot-Savart's law is a fundamental law and it plays a significant role in electromagnetic theory. By the end of this session, you will learn about the concept of magnetic field, properties of magnetic field lines and magnetic flux, Biot-Savart's law, limitations of Biot-Savart's law and its applications, force on a point charge in magnetic field, properties of magnetic field induction. Let us start this session with basic concept like magnetic field. What is magnetic field? A magnet is a material or object that produces magnetic field. A magnetic field is a vector field, means which consists of both magnitude and direction. Do you know what the natural magnet is? Lodestone is the natural magnet which was invented by ancient Greeks. Let us discuss deep insights of magnets. What are the types of magnets? Bar magnet, ring magnet, disc magnet, magnetic needle, horseshoe magnet, etc. What are the applications of magnets in our daily life? We can see the magnetic storage devices in computers, in medical field MRI scanning, compass which is used for navigation, location and direction, in speakers, in fridge doors, maglev trains which are very high speed trains, etc. What are the properties of magnets? Like poles of magnet will repel each other, means two south poles or two north poles. Unlike poles of magnet will attract each other, means one south pole and one north pole. Magnetic field lines are imaginary lines which is used to represent magnetic fields. They describe the direction of the magnetic force on a north monopole at any given position. Outside the magnet, the direction of magnetic field lines are from north to south pole, and inside the magnet, the direction is from south pole to north pole, means they are closed loops. As we already discussed, they denote the direction of the magnetic field. How can we find the direction? By drawing tangent. A tangent drawn to the magnetic field lines gives the direction of the magnetic field. One important point here is they never intersect each other. Why? If they intersect, we need to draw two tangents at that particular point, means two different directions at that point, which is not possible. That is why they never intersect each other. The density of the field lines is directly proportional to the strength of the field. These are the properties of magnetic field lines. What is magnetostatics? Magnetostatics is the study of magnetic fields in systems where the currents are steady, which is not changing with time. This phenomenon was first discovered by Oersted in 1820. The electric current creates the magnetic field. Earlier, scientists thought that electricity and magnetism both are unrelated. But after this discovery, they came to know that both are two aspects of single phenomenon. What is the source of magnet? The source of magnetic fields are magnets and constant electric fields. Electric current means charges in motion can create both electric field and magnetic field around it. If a charge is at rest, it creates only electric field. But when it is in motion, in addition to electric field, it creates magnetic field. Magnetic field strength denotes H. It refers to a physical quantity is used to measure the intensity of the magnetic field. It is a quantitative measure of the strength or weakness of the magnetic field, which does not depend upon medium. The units are ampere per meter. Magnetic flux density or magnetic induction denoted with B. It measures the number of magnetic field lines of flux that passes through a point on a surface. The units are Weber per meter square or Tesla. 1 Tesla is equal to 10 to the power 4 Gauss. The relation between them is B is equal to mu H, where mu is permeability, but for free space, B is equal to mu naught H. Mu naught is permeability of the free space. Mu naught is equals to 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 Newton per ampere square, which is very important in solving problems. Magnetic flux. The total number of magnetic field lines which are passing through a certain area is called magnetic flux. The formula is d phi b is equals to b dot ds. B is magnetic induction and s is surface area. By integrating on both sides, we can get the total flux. That is phi b is equals to ds cos theta, where theta is the angle between magnetic induction and surface area. The units are Weber. Different cases we can see here. If B and S both are at some angle, then the flux phi B is equals to BS cos theta. If B and S both are in the same direction, we can get the maximum flux phi B is equals to BS. If both are perpendicular direction, we can get zero flux. What if the surface is closed? We can see the closed surface objects here. For closed surface, magnetic flux is zero. Why? Because number of field lines entering into the surface is equals to number of field lines emerging from the surface. Means the number of field lines entering and emerging is same. So net flux is zero. How to calculate magnetic field induction? We have fundamental law in magnetostatics to calculate magnetic field induction. That is Biot-Savart law, our today's topic, which is analogous to Coulomb's law in electrostatics. We use to determine the magnetic field at a point near the current carrying conductor. It describes the magnetic field generated by constant current, which relates the magnetic field to the magnitude, direction, length and current. Let us consider a current carrying wire carrying current I creates a magnetic field around it. To calculate the magnetic field at a point P, let us consider current carrying segment called current element, which is making an angle theta with the position vector. The magnetic field is directly proportional to the following property: current flowing through the conductor I, length of the current element dl, sine of the angle between dl and point P, sin theta, inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the point, that is 1 by r square. On combining all these factors, dv is proportional to idl sin theta by r square. After removing the proportionality, we can get a constant mu naught by 4 pi. Then magnetic induction dB is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into idl sin theta by r square. Mu naught is permeability of the free space. The value is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per ampere square. In vector form, the Biot-Savart law is dB is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into idl cross r cap by r cube. To calculate the total magnetic field, we need to integrate it. Then B is equal to integral D. As we discussed, magnetic field is a vector, means it consists both magnitude and direction. So, what is the direction of magnetic field? By right hand thumb rule, we can define the direction of the magnetic field. Place your right hand thumb finger in the direction of the current. Then the curl of your fingers will give you the direction of magnetic field. Curl of your fingers. If it is inside the plain paper, then it is denoted with cross mark. If it is outside the plain paper, it is denoted with dot. You can able to see the difference here. Applications of Biot-Savart. We can use Biot-Savart law to calculate magnetic responses even at the atomic or molecular level. It is also used in aerodynamic theory to calculate velocity induced by vortex lines. Importance of Biot-Savart law. It is valid when the source current is sufficiently steady. It is valid for symmetrical current distributions. It is applicable to very small length too, which carrying current. If theta angle is 0, then dB is 0 because sin 0 is 0. Means there is no magnetic field induction at any point on the current carrying conductor. Applications of Biot-Savart. We have two applications here. The first application is magnetic field due to a long straight conductor carrying current. Consider infinitely long current carrying wire carrying the current I. It can create the magnetic field. Our aim is to calculate the magnetic induction B at a point P, which is at a distance r from the wire, and theta be the angle between direction of current and line joining the point. You can able to see in the diagram. By applying Biot-Savart law for current carrying wire, the magnetic induction is B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r. The units are Weber per meter square or Tesla. This is very important formula while doing the problems. We can see the lines of magnetic induction around the straight wire carrying the current. The observations from the diagram, magnetic field lines are concentric circles. You can see here, lines are denser near the conductor, rarer as the distance increases. Now, coming to second application. Magnetic field on the axis of circular loop. So, let us consider a circular coil of radius A carrying a current I and at point P, which is at a distance x from the center. You can see here, to calculate the magnetic induction at point P, consider a small element AB of length DL. This is called current element here. By applying Biot-Savart law for axis of circular loop, the magnetic induction B is equals to mu naught N I A square by 2 A square plus X square whole to the power 3 by 2. The units are Weber per meter square or Tesla. Here, capital N is number of turns. We have two different cases here. One is at the center of the coil. At the center, X is equals to 0. By substituting in B, then B is equals to mu naught N I by 2. And the second point is at a far point from the loop, A is very much less than X. So we can neglect A, then B is equals to mu naught N I A square by 2 X cube. Next important concept in magnetostatics is force on a point charge in magnetic field. When a particle is moving with velocity v, entering into the uniform magnetic field, a magnetic force acts on the particle. Here, the magnetic field is perpendicular and downward to the pitch. And the velocity v is perpendicular to the magnetic field, and the force acting on a charged particle is F is equals to Q into V cross B is equals to QVB sine theta. Here, theta is the angle between velocity and magnetic field. Force acting on the particle in uniform field is perpendicular to the plane consisting of velocity and magnetic field. A charge is moving with velocity V in uniform magnetic field B, then V is perpendicular to B. Path followed by the charged particle is circular. You can see in the diagram. We will see different cases of force on a particle in magnetic field. If a particle is at rest, means velocity is zero, it experiences no force. Particle moving along in the direction of magnetic field, then theta is equals to zero, then sine zero is zero, it experiences no force. Third, particle moving perpendicular to the magnetic field, then theta is equals to 90. Sine 90 degrees is equals to 1. It experiences maximum force. Work done by the magnetic force acting on the charged particle in uniform magnetic field is 0. The resultant path of the particle is helical path. You can see in the diagram, right? So, distance between the two successive circular paths is called pitch of the pitch. The formula for the pitch is the product of velocity and time, that is equals to 2 pi mv by q. When the particle is moving in magnetic field with velocity v, magnetic force will be acting on it, which provides the necessary centripetal force, and the path traveled by the particle will be circular. So, we can equate this centripetal force to the magnetic force. That is, F is equals to mv square by r is equals to qvb. From this, we can get the radius of the circle. This is very important formula. R is equals to mv by qb. So, we can find the angular velocity, angular frequency, time period of the particle here. So first, angular velocity. The formula for angular velocity omega is equals to v by r. By substituting r value here, omega is q v by m. Angular frequency, yeah, formula is omega by 2 pi. That is, by substituting omega here, we can get frequency q QB by 2pi is called cyclotron frequency. Then time period. Time period formula is 2pi by omega. By substituting omega here, we can get the time period T as 2pi m by Q. Here we can observe fast moving particles move in bigger circles and slow moving particles move in smaller circles. Now we will discuss two important aspects of magnetic field. The first one is divergence of magnetic field. As we already know, magnetic field lines are continuous. They join back to themselves. Free isolated magnetic poles does not exist. Magnetic monopoles always exist in pairs. So that we can write net magnetic flux is equals to zero. As we already discussed for closed loops, what is the flux? The flux phi b is equals to zero. Then integral b dot ds is equals to zero. By applying Gauss divergence theorem, we can write it as integral del dot b dv is equals to zero, because Gauss divergence theorem combines the surface integral to the volume integral. That is, del dot b is equal to zero. This is called Gauss law in magnetostatics, and also it is one of the Maxwell's equations. Second aspect is curl of the magnet. Thus, the curl of the magnetic field at any point is equal to the current density at that point, which can be written as integral B dot dl is equal to mu naught I, that is equal to mu naught integral J dot ds. Here J is current density. This equation is called as integral form of Ampere's law, which is very important. Integral form of Ampere's law. By applying Stokes' theorem, we can write integral del cross B ds is equal to mu naught integral J dot ds. So del cross B here, what is that? Mu naught J. This equation is called as differential form of Ampere's law. Previous one is integral form, now this is differential form. Integral form is integral B dot dl is equal to mu naught integral J dot ds. Differential form is del cross B is equal to mu naught J. By this equation, we can say that magnetic field is not a conservative field, because del cross B is not equal to zero. This is valid for static field. Children, now it is quiz time. I hope you all do the quiz with the knowledge gained till now. Okay, first question. The magnetic flux of magnetic field induction B over the closed surface. Options are zero, non-conservative, increase, constant. Answer is C. Because for closed surface, magnetic field induction is zero. Second, the magnetic field is formed due to. Options are moving charge, constant field, field distribution, all the above. Answer is moving charge. Because moving charge can create the magnetic field. Third, the relation between the magnetic field and magnetic intensity is. Options, B is equal to mu by H, mu is equal to B by H, mu is equal to H by B, mu is equal to B. Answer is mu is equal to B by H, because we studied B is equal to mu H. Your mu is permeability. Fourth, 1 Weber per meter square is equals to. Options are 10 Gauss, 10 to the power 3 Gauss, 10 to the power 2 Gauss, or 10 to the power 4 Gauss. Answer is 10 to the power 4 Gauss, that is equals to 1 Weber per meter square or 1 Tesla. Children, I have given some problems here along with the solutions. First question is, A long straight wire carries a current of 3.5 amperes. Find the magnetic induction at a point 0.2 meters from the wire. Here, the given data is current, that is 3.5 amperes. Distance r is equal to 0.2 meters. The formula is B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi. Right? We studied in Bio Savart's law. Right? So, by substituting all the values, here what is mu naught? Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7. I is equal to 3.5. R is equal to 0.2. By substituting all the values, we can get the magnetic field. That is 3.5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere per meter. Second question. An electron is moving with 50 meters per second velocity entering perpendicularly into the uniform magnetic field 2 Tesla. Calculate the magnetic force acting on the particle. What is the given data here? Velocity 50 meters per second and magnetic field 2 Tesla. And the particle is electron. So, charge of the electron 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. By substituting all these values in magnetic force, that is F is equal to qvb sin theta. By substituting all the values, theta is 90 here because it is entering into the magnetic field perpendicularly. So, sin 90. So, by combining all the values, we can get magnetic force, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 17. Newtons. Let us summarize the topic. First, we studied in this magnetic, what are magnets, magnetic field properties, what is flux. These are all the topics we discussed, right? So, let us summarize all the formulas which are very important from the magnetostatics. Okay? So, first one, relation between magnetic field and magnetic flux. B is equal to mu h. Here mu is the permeability, right? Suppose if it is for free space, B is equal to mu naught h. Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 newton per ampere square, right? Second point, magnetic flux phi b is equal to b s cos theta. Here b is magnetic induction, s is surface area, theta is the angle between both b and s. Third one, Biot-Savart law. Db is equal to mu naught by 4 pi idl cross r cap by r cube. Actually, this is vector form. Normally, we can say db is equal to mu naught by 4 pi idl sin theta by r square. Right? Next, fourth one. It is first application of Biot-Savart law. That is what? For a wire. Magnetic field due to a long straight conductor carrying current. That is B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi r, which is very important for semester as well as competitive exams. Next, magnetic field on the axis of a circular loop. It is second application of Biot-Savart's law that we studied. That B is equal to mu naught ni a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole to the power 3 by 2. Here capital N is what? Capital N is number of turns. And A is the radius of the loop. And x is the point from the center of the loop to the point where we are going to calculate the magnetic induction. Next, one of the most important formulas in magnetostatics is force on point charge in magnetic field. That is F is equal to Q into V cross B, QVB sin theta. Here, Q is the charge of the particle, V is the velocity of the particle, B is magnetic induction, theta is the angle between V and B, velocity and magnetic induction. Next, two important aspects here. One is divergence of magnetic field, that is del dot B is equal to 0. From this, we can say no magnetic poles, monopoles exist. Next, curl of the magnetic field, that is del cross B is equal to mu naught J. This is called differential form of Ampere's law. Thank you.